Growing up in Mobile, Alabama does not allow you to separate yourself from the legacy of the Civil War. The street I grew up on had the Civil War cannon that was painted every Friday night by the winner of the high school football game. I grew up going to Civil War forts for overnight birthday parties and battle reenactments. A few miles from my house is the place where the U.S. slave ship Clotilda carried captives from Africa into the United States for the last time. A place where many of the descendants of those enslaved Africans still live today, in a community called Africatown. My name is Sarah Eiland, and as you can tell, I'm a lifelong Southerner. I left the birthplace of Mardi Gras for the home of the blues and rock and roll. Being a Southerner has impacted every aspect of my life, including the way that I have participated in this project with Dr. Huebner to uncover the identities of the African-American men, women, and children who are sold less than 100 yards from where I'm standing right now. The process of digging through 150-year-old historical records may sound dry, but reading the bills of sale for slaves in Memphis is actually an incredibly emotional experience. It's so powerful to read each record of sale and realize and internalize that every descriptor is referring to a person, and every single price listed is a price put on someone's life. The title of today's event, The Service of Remembrance and Reconciliation, is an accurate description of the personal process of coming to terms with this collective, with our collective history, and is applicable to my own experience over the past two semesters while being part of this project. Remembrance begins with giving names to those who have remained nameless for so long. Every name that we found in this project represents a mother, a father, a son, a daughter, people like you and me, people who wanted the best for themselves and their families. But as a circumstance of their birth and skin color, we're not afforded those opportunities. Each name is representative of an entire life that deserves to be remembered and acknowledged. We owe the people who were sold the respect and dignity that they have deserved for so long, but have been denied. It is also an important opportunity for us to give back the individuality of each person sold here. As the history of slavery has only been told in broad brushstrokes and overgeneralized terms. The institution of slavery is, in many cases, talked about and taught as one large, ambiguous period of time. Except for a few Hollywood movies, the narrative of slavery is not told in individual terms. Over time, we have written these people out of history. Today, we write them back in. There can be no reconciliation without recognizing the stories of the people sold here. Their stories are hard to hear and even harder to come to terms with, but are important truths that must be grappled with in order for us to understand our own identities as Americans, as Southerners, and most immediately, Memphians. Truthfully, I have been numb to the true implications of the daily reminders of this era until now. Confederate forts have been nights of innocent fun, not the continued enslavement of my ancestors. Privilege has allowed me to grow on a street with a Civil War cannon, jog past antebellum-era homes without a second thought. My connection to the past around me had always seemed so clear before now. I had never been forced to truly understand the connections others may have to these same surroundings. The New Forest Slave Yard marker will allow future generations this same opportunity for remembrance and reconciliation that I have been afforded through this project. I am so very thankful to have had the opportunity to be a part of this research. Telling personal stories from an era lacking individuality and specificity will surely be a part of breaking this pattern of blindness that we have that allows us to ignore our surrounding history. Remember their names, recognize their lives, relive their stories. Because when people start to learn from other people, even histories can be changed.